Here I have an original Z80 processor. This came to the market in 1976 and was a very popular processor in early home computers like the ZX81, ZX Spectrum, Amstrad CPC, and it is still used in the TI-83 and 84 programmable calculators. In this video tutorial, I will show you how to bring it back to life with an Arduino Mega, a breadboard, and a bunch of jumper wires. Let's have a look at the CPU pinout. There are 16 address bus pins that can address up to 64 kilobytes of memory. Then there is the 8-bit data bus, the control pins for the CPU itself, external memory and IOs. And last but not least, the clock and power supply pins. Now look at the schematics. Let us connect address bus pin A0 to A9, the data bus D0 to D7, the CPU control lines and the clock with the Arduino as shown here. Because input pins are active low, unused pins must be connected to +5V. We scroll down through the manual and stop at the basic timing diagram. A Z80 instruction can consist of up to 3 machine cycles. First, the opcode fetch, where the Z80 gets an instruction from the memory. If the instruction needs any input value, a memory read cycle is executed. The result can then be written back to memory in a memory write cycle. Have a closer look on the instruction fetch cycle, also called M1 cycle. First, the M1 pin becomes active, indicating that the CPU is about to fetch an instruction now. After this, memory request and read become active. In the middle of the M1 cycle, the Z80 reads the instruction from the data bus. In the second half of the M1 cycle, the Z80 computes what to do in the next cycle. Depending on the opcode, this can either be another instruction fetch, a memory read or memory write. During this time, DRAM is being refreshed if there is any. But this is not interesting for us now. If the CPU decides to read data from the memory, it starts a memory read cycle, also called M2 cycle. Here, a memory request and read become active. With the last falling edge of the system clock, the Z80 reads the input values from the data bus. And in a memory write cycle, memory request also gets active. Later, write signals that the data is stable on the data bus now and can be written into RAM memory. In an input or output cycle, the CPU exchanges data with an I/O device like a serial console, printer, mass storage, or anything else. Other than in a memory cycle, the I/O request signal becomes active there. Read and write still indicate that the I/O device can put or read data to or from the data bus. The challenge now is to write an Arduino sketch that deals with these control signals and reads and writes the data from and to the data bus just in time. The program starts with the definition of macros that is reading and writing of the control signals. I write and read the port registers of the ADMEGA directly, because this is much faster than doing this with the Arduino library. In the setup function, I initialize the Arduino I/O ports, the pin interrupts, and the clock timer. The whole thing runs reliably at 100 kHz, which is fair enough for this test. Then, the byte array that simulates the memory is initialized and the Z80 resetted. And there is where the music plays. We have two inline functions, one for reading and one for writing the data bus. The first interrupt routine is called whenever the read signal becomes active. We distinguish two cases here. When memory request is active, we put the array element addressed by the macro adder to the data bus. The second routine is called when the write signal becomes active. If memory request is also active, the data is read from the data bus and copied to the array element addressed by the macro address. If memory request is not active, we consider I/O request active. In this case, we print the value which we read from the data bus to the serial port of the Arduino and we can see it in our terminal program. Let us write a small hello world program into the memory array now. The command out increment recursive OTR awaits the start address of the string to output in the HL register, its length in the B register, and IO address in the C register. Because the Arduino is our only IO device here, this value does not matter. 0x21 is the opcode that loads the HL register. So LDHL, we don't know the address yet. Now we write the C register with the IO address 0E00, we don't know yet. Now the B register with the length of the hello world string. So this is 0B, that means 11 characters. So mnemonic LDB11. Now comes the OTR command EDB3. And finally, we put in a halt command. This prevents from doing some odd things when running over the hello world string. So hello world. And finally, an escape character that starts a new line. So we're going to count the bytes until the hello world. So the H is at address 10. So 0A in here. And with the new line character, we have a 12 byte of length. So we just change B to C. Compile and start the sketch. And here on the serial console, we get the hello world. So every time when we reset the device, we get another hello world.